Let me ask you one bar before.
Yeah, we looked at later.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay.
So,
because,
okay. Due to harmonical reasons, there are enharmonic rewritings. And of course, I put it here like Yuhani also does it. If you have enharmonic rewriting in the scale description, I put it in the upper octave. So, and of course, here playing it on this spider keyboard, it is
it's the same
key. Okay, now let us first sing the Pajara, the pure Pajara style. We drop out the filled note and sing also the note what is in parentheses. So, and we start this time from A.
So we're just singing the real Pajara scale.
Real Pajara scale.
Oh,
sharp melodon to D sharp melodon, what interval is it in whole tone?
See, theta whole tone.
Theta whole tone.
Is that what I talked about?
Yeah, you could put it here, make visible.
Yeah, it might be also visible there, yeah.
Yeah.
That's a good idea how to modify that. Of
course,
I put here only the numbers, step numbers. Yeah, many, four. I don't. Yeah.
Sorry.
2 + 2 is 4.
At least.
So that number mathematics is of course the same, but of course as we have seen that if we add intervals together, say like sometimes end up on other intervals, so that we see that in porcupine we see that we have 3 minor thirds, minor sevenths, and not a major sixth.
Mm.
So this mathematics, and there are some sometimes you will discover some strange laws how the intervals act together differently. I haven't tracked that, but we should, as we, of course, we can say sometimes we have to compile some textbook for 22 music theory, and so we should collect all these things. Okay.
Ooh.
Of course, it's a bit hard to play from here all voices, I will not do that. We can go through these 3 voices, and then we will see it, that I find the tape for that.
Mm-hmm.
Tape, quotation mark. Okay. Please.
It's in unison for 4.
Yeah, it is
in
unison. The third voice is the only one.
The beginning is.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's unison for the first
time.
Besides
the
second voice, are unison.
Yes,
four.
And it. Then it goes two voice, and then it.
Here, the upper voice are unison.
And
but
then
here, until D, yeah.
Yeah, the first and second stay the same all the way.
Not for the rest of the B.
Yeah,
you can turn the P.
It's only a letter C, they split into 3.
Yeah,
I mean
C, oh, look at C. That is already.
So in letter C,
yeah.
We split. From letter C, we have 3 voice in the part. So,
okay, are you
first? Middle and.
Yeah.
So divide the.
Are you first or middle?
Mm-hmm.
I'm middle.
Mm-hmm. Okay. More complicated.
Because Christian is not in Saturday anyway, so
maybe
so
we.
In some way, have to manage. Maybe you are also middle or not.
Here?
So maybe
I can
see the
middle.
Yeah,
middle. I'm the middle here.
Yeah.
I can also have place.
Yeah,
no,
whatever.
Last year.
Anyway, we have to reorganize in some way. Yeah.
But now, for to become familiar, because it is not, I think it is not a very high piece. What is the highest pitch? D sharp down. So that let's sing all together, all voices, and for to become familiar. So of course, we later, if we do it again, we can drop out these unisono things quickly. But okay, let's start with the first voice. You don't have to sing the text. It's a larger water.
Mm-hmm.
can find also in and chose Tonescape. He made a Tonescape version from this progression, not from the piece. You did it.
I don't know what was.
You did my Pajara sequence.
The Pajara circle.
Yeah, but it's the same. But it's the same progression.
Oh, okay.
So this piece is based on this Pajara circle.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So Hans, could we please repeat the two bars before B, because
yeah, let's go again.
That
from
C sharp, D sharp,
yeah.
Arrow down was
okay.
Weird.
Yeah, my fault. So we have C sharp, D down, and then yeah, I want to emphasize.
That's a fourth.
Yeah. So D sharp to B flat up is a fourth. Please mark it. It's just I wrote it like this because then the B flat is a stepwise movement to A, and of course if I would write E flat, I don't know if there are better way to write it. Maybe I keep it like the like a user's piece that to the scale. Of course, if we have maybe we can.
You could write the other note.
You could have written the C sharp as a D flat up instead, and then the D sharp down as an E flat up instead. You could have done that.
Yeah, D sharp down, E flat as E flat up, and then a D flat
up.
Yeah, no D flat. Normally D flat, but
D flat up, E flat up, B flat up.
No D flat instead of C sharp in the part
right,
before.
D flat up.
No.
No.
C sharp is D flat.
Oh right, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I'm looking at your scale.
Yeah. Of course. Then. That's an idea. Maybe Johan pointed it sometimes out, but I didn't understand. So, I marked it D flat.
So it's C D flat.
C
flat.
Flat E flat. Arrow down.
Yeah, and then you can see the pause
in
the right manner.
No, wait, C sharp is not D flat, it's D down.
Now C sharp, every sharp is the same as the flat
pauses.
Isn't it?
No. No,
D
C
flat
sharp is the same as D down.
No.
All the arrows in the middle of the three black keys.
Okay.
C sharp down. You have one. Sorry, D down. Sorry, yeah. My mistake.
D down. Yeah, the C sharp is actually a D down.
Confused.
I said the wrong thing in the very beginning.
Okay, sorry. Yeah, D down.
So that's the same as D down, and then the D sharp down.
E flat.
Is the same as E flat up.
Then it's probably easier to Z.
Right. It's easier to see
C sharp
intervals when you write it that way.
Yeah, but of course then we have the F sharp. Yeah, I think the idea why I didn't do it, because then it we have flats and sharps because the third voice. And
right.
The third voice, so we have here a conflict of, so, and of course we can keep it like this, first voice has flats, the second voice or the first and second voice has flats, and the this voice has sharps. Doesn't matter. It's
right.
Maybe better than this, but I try to keep all in sharps.
I think it is good way to notate now, because we all know this Rimsky-Korsakov enharmonism or some Dvorak. So to go from one enharmonic to other, so it's actually clear. So.
But for simplicity, I think I will change it to the D down on E flat.
Also, you know, another thing to consider is that we're writing the book on 22 EDO harmony right now, anyway. So we're creating it. So
okay.
Who says you can't mix an F sharp down with an E flat up? Why not? Because
minus
key
signature anyway.
Yeah.
So
it's not the same as the traditional rule.
Yeah.
So.
I think I think it should be easier to do if we read a fourth as a fourth.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. So I think it's a good idea to rewrite it.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm steadily learning. So,
okay.
And don't bother about that. In one voice you have sharps, and the other voice you have jazz.
Yeah, the F sharp down.
What was the reason? Yeah, we have here. What is this? What is F sharp up?
It's a G flat.
It's a fifth.
Yeah.
It's a fifth. And that was my my intention to keep the fifth.
Where is
the fifth? We have a pure fifth between the voices.
D sharp. It's not a fifth.
Well, what is it?
It's a sixth.
Well, it's a sixth.
No, you're getting a minor chord there, that's all. You could actually rewrite the F sharp down as a G flat up, and it fits right in.
Yeah.
Ah, major
that's
six.
It. And you want to have it like with a B? What's the third?
Yeah.
Because, you know, it's going to a C anyway, so it's still some kind of a tritone. It doesn't matter if you write it as a F sharp down or a G flat up.
Or you can change the B flat as E. A sharp.
Right, well, he didn't want to do that because of the melodic.
I understand because of that connection, because the letter part, but by changing, I'm just counting the amount of notes that needs to be changed. This way we change only one, and it still makes sense.
Don't make too many notes.
Yeah.
And it still makes sense because then you can. Major track.
It doesn't matter how many notes we have to change because in the composition process you every time change notes. So it's because it's. Of course, we can say if he sacrifice this minor, so then we have a different high tone there.
It's more religious.
Okay.
Voodoo.
Okay, let's sing the voodoo. Number
six.
Thank you. Yeah.
In the middle.
Okay.